I'm so happy you're here. Welcome to The Tonight Show.
And welcome to my first talk show.
Yeah, this is it.
You're my first.
Yes! You guys are my first. That's what I'm talking about!
Wow.
I'm so excited. I am such a fan of yours, I've actually been dying to have you on the show. I'd just like to name a couple of the things that you've done, just in case you don't remember what you've
done.
Cheaper by the Dozen with Steve Martin. Date Night with Steve Carell and Tina Fey. Three Night at the Museum movies with Ben Stiller. Free Guy with Ryan Reynolds. The TV series Stranger Things. Hello! And now Deadpool and Wolverine. Come on, buddy. What are you talking about? Come on.
Wow.
What are you talking? How great is that?
I am exhausted. I am instantly exhausted.
But you started out acting, though, right?
I mean, I started out wanting to act.
Yes.
Like, I'm from Montreal. I'm from Canada. And I was like, are Canada in the house?
No, we allow two people from Canada every show.
Just two.
All right. Yep, there they are.
It's you and me.
Yeah.
It's you and me.
Oh, that's right. It's you two. Yeah, exactly. Right, yeah.
Yeah, so I went to college, and I moved out to L.A., and I'm like, I'm going to be an actor. And I'm instantly kind of going to these auditions, and in every callback is Paul Rudd. Like, this is literally, this is like, every time I got to like, oh, a callback, maybe I'm going to get it this time, Paul Rudd.
No.
And you know how that story ends.
Yeah.
He generally got the part.
Yeah, he did.
And I was like, okay, maybe this is the universe telling me I should pursue something different.
Really?
And then years later, I did the first of my Night at the Museum movies, cast Paul Rudd as the stepdad to Ben Stiller.
That's right.
Yes.
You go, yeah, I like that guy.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
So we found our place.
That's perfect. I was looking at some research on you, and I saw that one of your first acting roles was a movie called Zombie Nightmare.
Are we really? Wow, you want to? Okay, so just so I'm clear, with Dave Bautista, you show him looking like a golden god at age 16.
Yeah.
And now, just for the compare and contrast, you want to talk about this guy at 16?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So
explain Zombie Nightmare.
Zombie Nightmare, which I'm shocked, Jimmy, that you don't know Zombie Nightmare.
No, we all do.
It's an unheralded classic, so it's okay. No, it's exactly what you think.
Yeah.
It is an embarrassingly, kind of awesomely bad horror film. and I play, like, long-haired bad boy.
Oh.
And sadly, it still lurks out there on the internet. And I fear, Jimmy.
You do.
That you're gonna
show a clip?
You're gonna
confront me. Why would I ever do that when
I feel like Dave got 16-year-old Dave, but you and I, we're gonna kinda take a more humbling look at our history.
Here's a clip of Sean Levy in Zombie Nightmare. Take a look at this thing.
Boy.
You're not gonna get to your next birthday if you don't get your act together.
Not yours.
What did you say, you disrespectful punk? Kaya! Ah!
That's the best clip we've ever showed on The Tonight Show. That's the best clip we've ever showed of any movie.
I'm so flattered. You're being way too kind. It's suddenly so clear why I'm sitting here as a director and not
Are you eating a handful of pasta?
I'm eating a handful of cold spaghetti out of the fridge because I'm a rebel. And just in case you didn't get that message, I throw it at my mom's face.
Rude.
And take a bite.
Oh, my God.
Nothing but trouble.
Can we talk about Stranger Things? How did you get involved with that? When did you get involved in that?
I mean, literally, it was this script that some people had read, and everyone was like, well, wait, it's a show starring kids that isn't necessarily for kids, and it just was kind of going overlooked, and it came across my desk. When I first read it, I was like, I'm a movie director, I don't even do TV, and I read this thing, and it was just too good. You just knew. I didn't know if anyone would watch it, but I knew it was cool. I knew it was special. And so I said to the Duffer brothers, guys, I don't know what my role on this is going to be, but this has to get in the world. So I'll do whatever you need to help get this into the world. And here we are making season 5.
It's so different and good and fresh. I love it. You also got to direct a few.
Yeah, yeah, I direct a couple episodes every year, which is, I mean, directing's my happy place, which is weird, because you would think acting would have been
you would think,
yeah, a couple episodes, a year, and executive produce all of them with the Duffer Brothers and a great team.
Which
and
one did you do?
I did an episode, one of the more recent ones was called Dear Billy, and that was the episode where we used a Kate Bush song called Running Up That Hill.
Oh, yeah, that's you! Come on, bud!
And it's like, you just never know, right? You never know what are the things that are going to hit people in a way that's sick.
That song went back
in the charts. Oh, yeah. I mean, it was that was thrilling. That was so cool.
Are we allowed to say what's happening? No.
Not really.
No, not really.
I mean, not unless you want to get me in a lot of trouble.
No, that's true.
But we released a video recently, so I think the world knows we're like just past the halfway mark. We're shooting season 5. I can tell everyone, I mean, we want to get it out there to the world as much as the world is waiting for it.
Yeah.
But we want to make it great. We want to stick this landing. It's our last season.
Yes.
And everyone's back there making the show. And literally,
Duffer Brothers are awesome.
Duffers are in it. The cast is in it.
Sean Levy doesn't mess around. No. He doesn't mess around. He doesn't play. Doesn't play by your rules. Yours, Mom.
I'm just gonna take a sip of water from my Tonight Show mug on my first talk show.
You can take that home with you too.
I'm definitely stealing.
That's yours. Yeah.
I'm definitely stealing.
Yeah. I want to talk Deadpool and Wolverine. Let's talk. You directed it. You co-wrote it. Stars Ryan Reynolds and Hugh Jackman. Mm-hmm. Two of the most talented people, but two of the most nicest people I think you'll ever run into.
Yeah.
How did you meet either one of them?
I mean,
who'd you meet first?
I met Hugh back in like 2011. We made a movie called Real Steel.
Oh, yeah.
And we made this movie, Real Steel, and back then, this is true, like it's so crazy, but Hugh said to me back in 2011, you know, if you ever meet and work with Ryan Reynolds, you guys aren't ever gonna stop. He just kind of knew it. And then years later, I met Ryan, and we made our first movie together, Free Guy. And I was like, man, Hugh Jackman, handsome, yeah. Pretty good shape.
Pretty good.
Great actor.
Yeah.
And prophet. And
he saw the future.
It. Yeah, and so now Ryan and I, we did Free Guy, we did Adam Project, and now he asked me to join him on Deadpool and Wolverine.
Was it even a thought? Did he go, well, I'll get back to you?
Well, the funny thing is, Ryan, when he approached me, we were on set making Adam Project, and he's like, you know, I think I'll only do this third Deadpool movie if you do it with me. And I know you're going to say no, because you do original films, and you like doing new stuff. And I'm thinking, man, I'm already at yes.
I'm in, man.
I was in within a sentence, I was in, because I love Marvel movies.
Yeah.
It felt like, you know, here's a chance to do something surprising, a different kind of MCU movie. And that was even before we knew Wolverine was going to come back.
That's right.
That literally, we were...
It was just Deadpool 3.
Deadpool 3. We spent months trying to come up with story ideas that felt, you know, true to the audacious Deadpool tone, but fitting for the MCU, and we weren't cracking it. And we were going to tell Kevin Feige at Marvel, you know what? It's not happening. We'll come back to this in like a year or two. And that day, no joke, that day, Hugh Jackman called. He called Ryan. He goes, I want in. I want to see that Deadpool Wolverine movie out of the blue. And that day.
He said that he would never do Wolverine again.
Right, and he meant it. Like, yeah. Logan was a masterpiece of a movie.
Yes.
But we thought there was an opportunity not step on the sacred ground of Logan,
yep,
but to tell a different kind of story and to see what this pair-up might be between these two iconic characters who are so, like, mismatched, but that's a great starting point for comedy, for conflict, and ultimately it's this movie about friendship made by real-world friends.
Yeah. I cannot wait to see this. I want to show a clip. Here's Ryan Reynolds and Hugh Jackman in Deadpool and Wolverine. Take a look at this.
Just give me one more drink and then I'll leave.
That's not how it works.
It does now. Leave the bottle.
I know you, Bub.
Nope, but I know you.
Everybody knows me. I'm the Wolverine.
Yes, you are, and I'm gonna need you to come with me right now.
Look, lady, I'm not interested.
Really getting into your cups.
Why would I go with you?
Because, unfortunately, I need you, and even more unfortunately, my entire world needs you.
You two gonna f- or fight?
You gonna take that from him?
Yep.
I could tell you have a sort of don't get too close, I'll only break your heart vibe going here, but every other Wolverine would have really hurt me by now, and I'm sort of on the tick-tick, so upsy-daisy, here we go. Whoa, whoa.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about! Sean Levy, everybody! Deadpool and Wolverine opens in theaters and IMAX July 26th. You can have that mug. Glass Animals performs after the break. Stick around, everybody. Hey, hey.